because it was a story of a little boy whose mother's slippers were broken at home. And he came along and said, the first thing he said as he walked in the door, "My mummy's slippers are broken. I want to make her new slippers." And the teacher immediately said, "Great." He spent the entire morning creating these slippers. And he looked at the teacher's shoes and he thought, oh, they had a slipper-like quality. He took his design from there and off he went with his glue gun and his sheepskin and his, you know, it was a really rich task. And he developed these slippers with some, he had a bit of support, I think, when he came to use the sheepskin. It's pretty hard to cut sheepskin. Got a bit of help from that. And then, and so when he'd finished, they were quite magnificent. I could send you a photo. And he wrapped them up and gave them to his mother just after mat time. And Shalu held these as she opened them and held them to her breast. She said, "Oh, a gift to be treasured for a lifetime." And you know, he could, she could have, the teacher could have written about the maths, the technology, you know, all of, like, so much, the art, the communication, the disposition of persistence, the responsibility, you know, there were so many learning opportunities. But she chose to say, just what a fabulous, caring child. You've seen something and you've taken this action. We're so proud of you. And, you know, it was just this lovely little response. So, not long after that, Vinny heads off to school. And actually, the mother is already the, she's actually, she's written back and she's almost done more assessment than the teachers have done in this, in the written documentation. So off they go. 2 years later, she knocks on the door and says, "Oh, I've come to get another copy of Vinny's story." Because in those days it wasn't digitized. And the teacher said, "Oh, we're onto it now. We can give you a CD with all his stories on," which is what they did. And they printed off the story. And then they said, and then she said, "Actually, I also want you all to come and have afternoon tea at home." So off they went. Well, when they got home for afternoon tea and went into the lounge, there in the lounge, in a cabinet specially made, were Vinnie's slippers attached in Velcro to the box, the cabinet, with the learning story in shreds beside it. And they said, "Everyone who comes, family and friend, has to take their shoe, they put these slippers, they take the slippers out, they put them on the feet, and they read the story."
What an
Now,
incredible tradition.
a tradition that has emerged in that family. I know Vinny's going to be reading that to his grandchildren.